about to read from the book Stories of Don Bosco. On her old business card.
Right, ready?
Yes, sir.
Timely help.
It also says in the Bible not to call any man father. So therefore, I told you to call me Daniel. And I don't like kissing people's hands. There was a priest that told Janine, treat me as if I am God. Do you see? So I don't want to worship another man. Therefore, I don't hang out with the Catholics as much as possible. They call their priests father. You see? Yet, where do I get my food from? Don Bosco, why would he become so famous as Don Bosco instead of Father Bosco? You see? He had his beliefs, and he believed in calling people Father, but he must have read the Bible where it says don't. But instead of leaving the priesthood and starting his own, he started his own inside it, inside the priesthood. Go ahead and read, son.
Father Joseph Colosso, the pastor of Becky,
was called... I think it's called Becky. It could be Becci. I'm not sure. It's in Italian.
Was coming away from the mission one evening when he finds himself confronted by a sturdy, bright-looking boy of 11 years with thick, curly hair. Well, my little man, did you understand anything of what the preacher said? I think so, Father. You did. Therefore, Porter, repeat for me a few words of the sermon of this evening. I think I could repeat the whole sermon. Too late, John realized he should not have boasted so much and began to blush. But he did repeat the sermon point for point. Father Colosso was surprised. And the sermon of this morning, do you remember that too? Yes, Father, let's hear it. John repeated the second sermon from beginning to end. My goodness, Father Colosso was amazed. All I expected to hear was the title. What's your name? My name is John Bosco, and I live in Becky. My father is dead, and my mother is Margaret Bosco, and she has 4 months. In a few moments, John had told him all there was to know about the book. That covers everything, John, said the priest. Concerned that such an intelligence should not go to waste, he went on. Would you like to study? Of course, Father, but my brother Anthony won't let me. Don't worry. Tell your mother to see me, and we'll talk it over. Before John left, he had to go to the rectory and dictate to Father Colosso the sermon of the evening. John ran home to tell his mother what had happened, and Margaret lost no time in calling on the pastor, who assured her he would do all in his power to help John in this thing. As the days passed, however, and John did not show up to the rectory, the pastor, on making inquiries, was told that Anthony would not allow it. But I want you to study, he insisted. Tomorrow you come into my house with your books and start studying. When John went to study with Father Colosso, he took his first decisive step toward his goal. Italian grammar, composition, Latin grammar, translation. For John to read it once was to remember it for good. If you continue like this, exclaimed Father Colosso, in no time at all you have learned everything there is to learn. Life went on pleasantly for John until one day he came home to pick up some articles of clothing. Suddenly a messenger rushed into the house to tell him that Father Colossal had taken ill and was calling for him. Dropping everything, John ran to the priest's house. Unfortunately, by the time he arrived, Father Colossal had already lost his power of speech and could only make signs for him to approach. With trembling fingers, he took a key from his pocket and handed it to John. With more signs, he made John understand that he was not to give the key to anyone, and that what was in the desk was meant for him. Accordingly, John put the key in his pocket, and with tears in his eyes, began to pray for his dying benefactor. Later, the royal official arrived for the reading of the will. "I have the key to Mr. Colossal's desk," John told him. "He gave it to me, and in the presence of others, made me understand that I was to take what was inside. And as soon as he saw how much trouble and confusion would arise over the division of the dead man's property, rather than the cause of his son,
that was it?
Yep.
So, what did you learn about John Bosco? Son, I see you as a saint. You may fall and make mistakes like regular men, but you are destined to be the centurion, the saint. You understand? Maybe you know too much, but to whom much is given, much is expected.